हेलो हेलो, हाँ हेलो, कैन यू ऑल लिसन मी नाउ? एम आई ऑडिबल? यस यस, ओके ओके। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून अंजलि, ओके जैस्मिन, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून मैत्री। गुड आफ्टरनून हनोक, गुड आफ्टरनून सुरेंद्र, गुड आफ्टरनून सिदर्शक, यस गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून 1920 फिरदौस, गुड आफ्टरनून संतोष, गुड आफ्टरनून, हेलो हेलो बेटा अनुषा, गुड आफ्टरनून निहारका, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून शशांक, विनय, गुड आफ्टरनून, बट आई इट विल स्टार्ट बाई 12:15, ओके? व्हाट डू यू से स्टार्ट इन तेलुगु? हाउ डू यू से गुड आफ्टरनून कीर्ति? हाउ डू यू से स्टार्ट इन तेलुगु? चेंडी, ओके चेंडी, मुडालू पट्टू पट्टू, ओके चेंडी, ओके ओके ओके। सो हाउ वाज स्टडीज क्लास? हाउ वाज स्टडीज क्लास? गुड आफ्टरनून तनु सुदर्शन, गुड गुड गुड, ग्रेट गोपा, ओके बागुंडी, व्हाट डू आई अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम बागुंडी? अनुषा वावनी, ओके नाइस नाइस, ओके ग्रेट। सो आई हैव लर्न्ड अ न्यू न्यू वर्ड, बागुंडी, ओके। सो वेटिंग फॉर फ्यू मिनट्स, है ना, लेट अदर स्टूडेंट्स आल्सो ज्वाइन। टेक्स्ट बुक्स, रिगार्डिंग टेक्स्ट बुक्स आई विल टेलिंग यू, फॉर नाउ यू यू विल नॉट बी रिक्वायरिंग एनी टेक्स्ट बुक। फॉर नाउ यू जस्ट रीड व्हाट एवर यू आर हैविंग फॉर 9th एंड 10th क्लास, जस्ट रीड दोज चैप्टर्स विच एवर यू आर हैविंग। सर कैन यू यूज फ्यू हिंदी वर्ड्स वाइल टीचिंग क्लास? आई कैन यूज, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द क्लास विल नॉट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इट। ओके यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड, ग्रेट गोपा, आई विल बी यूजिंग, ओके। व्हाट द वर्ड्स विच वी कांट अंडरस्टैंड इन इंग्लिश? सी स्लोली स्लोली यू विल बी गेटिंग अकस्टम्ड विद मी। आई कैन, ओ यू आर सुपर 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 डुपर रजनीकांत ऑफ अवर क्लास 1920। Great. So now it's your job to have good grip on chemistry also, right? 1920. Sir, my name is Siraj. Okay, good. What happened in 1920? It's fine. Okay. So, any doubt from the last class which you want me to repeat, which you want me to say? No. Okay. Let the other student come. Okay. So you all have to remember that class starts from. Okay, no, no issues, no issues, Siraj. I'll be repeating the things and I'll be providing notes once the process is done. So I'll be providing the notes. in that case you can read from there, and if you are having any doubt, so I'll be clear in there. Yes, I can see there are few new names. Few new names have joined the today's class, where this class is recorded. You will be getting permission from the center about the last class and all the other classes. It's good to be naughty, but it should be in a controlled manner. No issues, Reddy. No issues. If you have not listened to the last class, I'll be repeating the things, and we will be moving ahead. I'll be quickly recapping it, repeating it. So it's a request to all, please join the class at 12:15, by anyhow by 12:15. Good afternoon, beta. Good afternoon. Yes, I'll be discussing the latent heat concept. Study. I have just written latent heat. Today's class we will be studying that in detail. Okay. Why? What happened? What happened, Mohan? Yes, I'll be repeating the, just wait for 2 minutes more. We will be starting the class by 12:20 anyhow. Okay. See, it's a request to all of you. Do not chat with each other. Get the number or get with your friend in contact after the class. Okay. So this is not a place to chat with a friend. It's just a humble request to all of you. Okay. Just leave the class and join again. Leave the class and join again. Okay, so good afternoon to all of you who have joined now. We will be starting the class by 12:20, but we have to start our class by 12:15. Okay, so whatever I have written in here, is that clear? You can read it. Good afternoon, Deepak. Good afternoon. Yes. So is it readable, bro? Is it readable? Yes, Firdaus. Okay. Yes, sir. It is clear. So I'll be using this kind of font. Okay. So this is chemistry. Today we will be studying about matter. Okay. We will be continuing on matter. We already had one class today. So we'll continuing that. Yes, so I am audible, I am loud and clear, and my writing is readable to all of you. Yes, okay, just wait for one more minute. Okay. So I can see there are many students who have joined today only. So it's a request, kindly keep your mic off, right? Whenever it is asked you to unmute, then only you unmute it, and avoid writing in chat while I am writing on the board, because I will not be able to read your comment at that time. So your comment will not be visible to me. So write comment when I am done with the writing. Okay, or while I am asking you, your video is lagging, you leave the meeting and then rejoin it. Okay, so let us start our class. See, in last class, we have understood what is matter. What is matter? I told you anything which occupies space, anything which occupies space and have mass is known as matter. So two things are there, space and mass. Apart from matter, universe consists of matter as well as energy. So if we want to understand, universe is made up of what? It is made up of matter as well as energy, right? So these two things it is made up of. In today's class, we are discussing matter. So anything which occupies space and have mass will be known as matter. The other thing which we studied earlier, it was the characteristics of the matter. So first characteristic of the matter was, it consists of large number of particles. Consists mean it is made up of large number of particles. Okay. There is gap present between the particles. Space present. Very nice. There will be space or gap present between the particles. Particles. And the last point was, particles will be in motion. Great. Particles will always be in motion. So these three points were characteristics of any matter. If you take any matter, all these three basic characteristics will be present there. Okay? Yes, very nice. And the motion of particles will be depend upon the temperature. On increasing the temperature, the motion of particles will increase. That is very important point, because today we are going to cover interconversion of various states of matter. So for that, the temperature impact, the effect of temperature, we should know what is the effect of temperature on the motion of particles. So these are three basic points which we have studied earlier. Okay. So apart from these three things, is it clear to all the students who have joined today? Is it clear with all the students who have joined today? Okay. Is it clear with all the students? Yes, sir. Okay, fine. So large number of particles, space between the particles and particle will always be in the motion, right? We have subdivided or classified matter into various states on the basis of physical properties. How they look, how dense they are. So on the basis of this, we have divided matter into basically five things. First was solid. It is also very rigid. If you imagine any solid, you will find that it is rigid in nature. Then other thing was liquid. Then gases. Both of these things are also known as fluids. If there is a term in a question, what are the fluids? Then liquid as well as gases behave as fluids. Then there was a term plasma. generally we do not see plasma in our daily life, but if we observe tube lights, if we observe fluorescent lights, then we can see, we actually cannot see through our naked eyes, or we cannot feel, but the lighting and all the brightness that is coming in that fluorescent light is due to plasma. So plasma, what are plasma? They are super hot particles. Super hot particles. And it is made up of electrons and atoms. So basically they are charged particles. They are super hot particles, and you can find them in stars. When there are reactions going on in stars, you will find them. You will find plasma over there. And the last thing was BEC, that is Bose-Einstein condensate. They are just opposite. We can say just opposite of plasma, and they are super cold particles. Super cold. Okay. So for our 11th and 12th NEET and JEE purpose, we are not going to go into the details of the plasma as well as BEC, but we are going to study all these three in detail. Right? We are all, we need to study solid, liquid as well as gases in detail, right? And there will be always few questions in exam on the solid or liquid or gas. So we have studied what is the difference between solid, liquid and gas. Everyone knows that atomic, interatomic distance between solid is very less. The interatomic distance between solid is very less. The intermolecular force in solid is the highest, right? While in the case of liquid, the interatomic distance is moderate, and in gases it is lowest. So in gases particles will be like this, right? The force in between the particles will be minimum, right? Intermolecular force means the force present between the two particles, right? This is generally of attractive nature. Up to a certain distance, particles tries to attract each other, and because of this attraction, a force arises which is known as interatomic force. Interatomic between two atoms, right? So I was talking about gases. So in the gases, the interatomic force will be the least. Interatomic force will be the least. So the distance between the particles will be maximum. Okay? Because of least interatomic force, the particles will be moving. And whenever the particles are moving, they will always move in straight line. Okay? They will move in straight line like this. They will go here. Then after collision with this particle, they will change their direction like this. Right? Then after colliding with this, they will move in this direction. So the motion will be in straight line. Motion will be in straight line. Important point. Straight line, not curvilinear nature. The way we move bicycle or cycle, you have seen. Okay? The motion will always be in straight line. They will always move in straight line. Then they will be colliding with the particles. So the nature of collision will be elastic in nature. It will be elastic in nature. Do you understand what is elastic? What do you understand by elastic collision? Any one of you? What do you mean by elastic collision? ओके नो बेटा दे इन नॉर्मल और इन नॉर्मल लैंग्वेज वी मीन इलास्टिक मीन्स स्ट्रेचिंग और फ्लेक्सिबल बट इन फिजिक्स यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न द इलास्टिसिटी इलास्टिक एंड नॉन इलास्टिक कोलिजन सो इलास्टिक कोलिजन मीन्स इन इन दोज टाइप ऑफ कोलिजन द एक्सचेंज ऑफ एनर्जी द टोटल एनर्जी विल रिमेन ऑलवेज सेम द एनर्जी ऑफ द सिस्टम विल ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम नो लॉस ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी नाइस ग्रेट लेट्स से कि आई एम हैविंग 20 किलोजूल एंड द अदर गाय इज हैविंग 50 किलोजूल आफ्टर द कोलिजन द समेशन ऑफ एनर्जी विल रिमेन 20 प्लस 50 दैट इज 70 यस एनर्जी विल ऑलवेज रिमेन कंजर्व सो कंसिडरिंग दैट द कोलिजन बिटवीन द पार्टिकल्स विल ऑलवेज रिमेन इलास्टिक एंड देयर एनर्जी देयर विल नॉट बी any loss of energy so you all can write what is elastic collision elastic collisions can be defined as collision in which total energy is always conserved you will study that in very detail in physics right so we have studied the motion it will always be in straight Can you see the motion is of zigzag nature? So the motion of gaseous particles is of zigzag nature. So there was a one scientist and he named this type of motion as Brownian motion. Okay, so the zigzag motion of the gaseous particle is known as Brownian motion. So I think, did you understand the what is Brownian motion? Yes, the zigzag motion. You can just remember two words: zigzag and motion. Okay, so the motion will be in a straight line. But after colliding with another particle, the direction of the first particle will change. Anna, you can see here. Okay, so we have understood what is the difference between solid, liquid, and gases. Solid are the most highest. They will be having highest density. Yes, the zigzag motion. Liquid will be having the moderate density, and gases will be having the least dense. They will be least dense because the spaces between the particle. In case of gases is highest okay so I think till now everything is clear shall we move ahead what is the difference between solid liquid gas and what is Brownian motion I think these things are clear yes sir so which of solid liquid and gas is most flexible Or we can say most compressible. Which is the most compressible among all three? Gas. Why? Why is it so? Why they are most compressible? Intermolecular spaces. Yes, they encompasses large intermolecular spaces. So, do you understand by the term interatomic spaces, intermolecular or interparticle? Interparticle matlab it means between two particles okay I am writing over here right so you need to learn there is inter and there will be another term coming that is intra so we will understand later what is intra right now you must understand what is inter okay so can I rub it shall we move ahead Yes, because they have large intermolecular space. Great. Shall we move ahead? Yes. Okay. Fine. So I think all of you have understood what is the difference between solid, liquid, and gases. Okay. So I'll be. So what is your doubt, Kirti? Yes, Kirti. Tell me what is your doubt. राइट 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 इट राइट योर डाउट बेटा. Explain once again about what thing? About what? Solid, liquid gases, or explain once again, sir? Can you explain elastic collision? Right. Okay. Okay. Elastic collision. Let's say there is a particle. Okay. Let's say there is a particle coming with 2 kilojoule, and there is another particle coming with 5 kilojoule, right? They are approaching each other. They are approaching each other. We have to know just the basic of elastic collision. You will be knowing it about in physics in very detail. You will be solving many problems. But let us understand what is elastic collision. Let's say this is A sphere and this is B sphere. It is having 2 kilojoule energy, and it is having 5 kilojoule energy. After the collision, this is before the collision. Before the collision, let's say after the collision, energy of A decreases. Let's say they collided, and after the collision, A moves in this direction, and B moves in backward direction, like this. Let's say ki A is having 1 kilojoule after the collision. If we are going to measure the energy of B, it must be 6 kilojoule. Okay. So what do I want to tell you? I want to tell you that the summation of energy before the collision and after the collision will remain same. There will be no loss of energy. That's it. Elastic collision means there will be no loss. There will be no loss of energy. Okay. In chemistry, you have to understand only this. There will be no loss of energy. Total energy of the system will remain same. So total energy here, it is also 2 plus 5. And after the collision also 1 plus 6. Okay, if the energy of one substance decreases, the energy of other substance will increase. Fine. Is it clear, beta, about elastic collision? Okay, right. See, solids are like this. They are closely packed. They are closely packed. These are solids. But if we talk about liquids, their particles will not be closely packed. The spaces between the particles will be more. Okay? The spaces between the particle will be more. Yes, there will always be present some gap in liquid. So they will be more compressible as compared to solid. The interatomic distance in case of liquid will be more. The interatomic distance between the liquid will be the interatomic distance between the liquid will be more as compared to solid. Brownian motion. Okay, I'll be explaining Brownian motion again, right? So definition of the elastic collision is simple. There will be no loss of energy. Okay, collisions in which the energy remains conserved. Okay, you just remember there will be no loss of energy. It does not happen in real cases. Whenever two particles collide, the energy loss happen. Okay, but in case of elastic collisions, the loss of energy will be zero. That's it. Brownian motion is nothing but zigzag motion. Brownian motion is nothing but zigzag motion. Zigzag motion. Okay, zigzag motion. Zigzag motion in straight line. How do you understand? A particle will move in this direction, then after collision it can go here, it can go here, it can go here, but the motion will always remain in straight line. Okay, yes, zigzag motion, right? So I think all these three concepts, two important concept, Brownian motion and elastic collision, okay, they are clear. Shall we move ahead, beta? Yes, okay. So till now everything is clear. Admit karo na. Sir, zigzag motion occurs only. No, it will also occur in liquids, right? What happens if you put a water? If you put glass into the water and you put pollen grains over here. If you put pollen grains over here, pollen grains. Okay, if you heat up, the particles in this thing will be doing zigzag motion. If do you know what are collides? It can also happen in liquids also. It can happen in liquids also. No, it will not be happening in solid, but it will be happening in liquid as well as gases, right? In liquids also, zigzag motion is observed. We will study that in detail when we will be studying surface chemistry. Okay, sir? Great. See, solid particles are closely packed. So their movement is not possible. They can only vibrate about their position. They can vibrate. Okay? They cannot move. Okay? So the next thing is interconversion of the states. Next thing is interconversion of the states of matter with change in temperature at given pressure. Temperature at given pressure. Right. Next thing is, this is our topic. Okay. Interconversion. It is interconversion. What do we understand by interconversion? It is just, see, now we have to focus only on three things, that is solid, liquid, and gases. Okay. Solid, liquid, and gases are important states for us. We have to study these three states in detail, right? So what do we understand about interconversion? Solid getting converted into liquid, or liquid is getting converted into solid, right? Both the process will be known as interconversion. Conversion of solid into liquid or liquid into solid. Solid into liquid into vapor or vapor into liquid. The other thing is, there are some solids which directly converted into, which get directly converted into vapor or gas, right? And the vice versa of the process can also happen. Okay? What is the example for solid into liquid? Any example which you can recall? It is ice getting converted into water. Right? So the conversion of ice into water will be known as, what do we term it? No, I am not talking about temperature. solid into liquid, the process will be known as the liquid into vapor. If we are converting liquid into vapor, like water into water vapor, it is known as vaporization. The conversion of water into vapor will be known as vaporization. Evaporation is a process. That's a different process. We will understand it. Evaporation. Yes, vaporization. No, not smelting. No, no, no. And the process of conversion of solid into direct vapor or gas is known as sublimation. It is known as sublimation. See, so let me put all these three in a simple one chart. If solid gets converted into liquid, the process is known as melting. It is known as melting, right? If liquid is converted into vapor, the process is known as vaporization. If solid is converted into vapor, it is known as sublimation. Is that clear? Is that clear with all? Then we can move ahead. ब्लू मार्कर है क्या? ये ब्लू नहीं चल रहा. नया ये पता नहीं क्यों ऐसा है. ओके बेटा, if liquid is getting converted into solid, it will be known as freezing. This is freezing, right? Freezing. And if vapor is converted into liquid, it is known as condensation. Condensation. And the process of vapor to solid is also known as sublimation. There is no difference. Okay. All six terms, five terms are clear. I will be discussing about evaporation, right? Evaporation and what is the difference between boiling and evaporation, that I will be discussing, right? So all these six terms are clear. If solid is converted into liquid, it will be known as melting. If liquid is converted into vapor, it will be known as vaporization. If vapor is directly converted into solid, then it will be known as sublimation. So these are few terms which you have to know, right? So what is melting point? Let us understand what is melting point. What is melting point? Before understanding melting point, let us understand by the example of ice. By the example of ice, let's say ki I have taken out a piece of ice from your refrigerator. Okay, I have taken a piece of ice from your refrigerator. This is ice, and we checked its temperature. Let's say I have checked its temperature, and its temperature is -5°C. Is it okay? I have taken a piece of ice from the refrigerator, and through the thermometer we have checked its temperature. Jab humne iska temperature check kiya, then we find it that the temperature is 5°C. We started heating it up. We started providing the heat. If we provide the heat, what we have observed, the temperature of this ice changed. Slowly, the temperature of this ice started raising. It increasing. The temperature started increasing. Okay. Why the temperature of the ice
is increasing. Why the temperature of ice is increasing? On because we are providing heat. Because we are providing heat. Okay. So on providing heat, the temperature of the ice started increasing. At certain point of time, when temperature of ice becomes 0 degrees Celsius, it becomes 0 degrees Celsius. At that point of time, if we are providing heat, we have seen the temperature stops increasing. At that point, when temperature reaches 0 degrees Celsius, for ice, if we provide extra heat, the temperature is not increasing. But we have seen another phenomena. At this time, it starts melting. It starts get converting into liquid. Okay, so ice starts converting into water. So the heat provided at this moment of time, when temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, is not increasing the temperature, but it is getting utilized. But it is getting utilized to break the intermolecular forces of ice. Did you get what I said right now? Did you get? At the 0 degrees Celsius, whatever heat is provided, it did not increase the temperature. We are seeing the thermometer, but on thermometer, we are not seeing any change. We are seeing the temperature is still 0 degrees Celsius. So all the heat which is provided at this moment of time is getting utilized to break the bonds of ice, break the strong bonds of ice. Temperature is not increasing, right? Temperature is not increasing because that whatever the heat we are providing, it is utilized somewhere else. It is utilized in breaking of the strong bond of ice. So let's say these are the bonds. So if we are providing heat, then slowly these bonds are breaking. Okay. And the ice is getting converted into liquid. Is it clear? Yes. So temperature will not change. I'll write the definition. Temperature at 0 degrees Celsius for ice. Okay. For ice, it will not change until all the ice is converted into water. Until all the ice is converted into water, till then, the temperature of the ice will not change at 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Okay. So we will come back to this concept again. First, let us write what is melting point. You can write melting point as temperature at which solid get converted into liquid at given pressure. See, at this moment of time, when the temperature is 5 degrees Celsius, we were giving heat, but it is not melting. It is not melting at room temperature. It is not melting at 1 atm pressure. At 5 degrees Celsius, whatever heat is given, it is going into the, to increase the temperature. Okay. But when 0 degrees Celsius is reached, at this moment of time, all the heat is utilized to change ice into water. It is utilized into the phase change. Okay. So that moment of time is known as melting point. So the temperature at which solid get converted into liquid is known as melting point. So what happens at the time of when we reach the melting point, the heat given at that moment of time goes into to is utilized to break the bonds of the solid. It is utilized to break the bonds of solid. No, these are two different terms. I'll be explaining later in a while. Let us understand another point, that is boiling point. Boiling point. It can also be defined in a similar manner. Temperature at which liquid get converted into gas or vapor. You can write gas. At given pressure. Okay, I'll be explaining through a graph also. I'll be trying to tell you this phenomena through graph also, so that you all get acquainted with the graph. How do we represent things on graph? Okay, so I'll be explaining all these three concepts through graph also. So just wait for some minutes. So this is melting point, temperature at which solid get converted into liquid, and boiling point is temperature at which liquid get converted into gas. Is that clear, beta? Is that clear? Yes. Okay. Fine. So you have to remember, for water, water for H2O is structure. You can write the molecular H2O. Melting point is 0 degree Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Boiling point is 100 degree Celsius or 373 Kelvin. So SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. So you must remember the relation between Celsius and Kelvin. Sir, is Sunday test instead MCQs? We have written test also. Do not worry about test right now. Okay, just focus on the class. We'll be discussing about that later. Okay, for H2O, melting point is 0 degree Celsius and boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. Is that clear for all? You have to remember these values. Okay, you do not have to remember the melting point of other substances. If they will ask the question, they will be providing you the values of melting and boiling point for other substances. But for water, they expect you to remember melting and boiling point. Right? Is that clear? Okay. No, you do not have to remember melting point or boiling point of solidification is freezing. The name itself tells solidification. Fication, your terms tell it is the process through which solid is forming from liquid state. So you can tell solidification is conversion of liquid into solid. So shall we move ahead? Shall we discuss latent heat? Okay. Bagundi. Latent heat, very important concept, beta, the latent heat. Latent heat, what do you understand by latent? I have told you in latent heat. What is the meaning of latent? Latent means hidden. Hidden means chupa hua. What do you say in Telugu, chupa hua? Hidden? What do you say hidden in Telugu? Oh,
it's bit difficult for me to pronounce. Dasu kovadam. Okay, dasuko. Okay, as heat, the heat which is hidden, the heat which is hidden, which we cannot appreciate or observe through our naked eyes. The heat which we cannot appreciate. Okay. Yes. 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 Okay. Okay. So let us understand what is latent heat. Latent heat can be defined as energy required to convert a substance from one state to another state. Energy required to convert a substance from one state to another. Okay, the energy which is required, it is simple beta. Heat required to convert one substance from one state to another. Very nice, Deepak. It is very correctly written. The energy required to convert a substance from one state to other. Okay, so it is known as latent heat, or it might be written as heat capacity. Okay, it can also be written as heat capacity. But we will be understanding those terms later. First, we should understand what is latent heat. Okay, if there is written latent heat of fusion, latent heat of fusion, what do you understand by latent heat of fusion? It is, if it is written latent heat of fusion, the energy required to convert solid into liquid. Great. Varno kya? Energy required to convert solid into liquid. It's talking about solid into liquid. The state here is solid and final state is liquid. If it is written latent heat of vaporization, if there is written latent heat of vaporization, latent heat of vaporization, what will you understand by this term? Yes, vaporization means the process in which liquid is getting converted into vapor. So the energy required to convert liquid into vapor will be termed as latent heat of vaporization. Okay. So if we say latent heat of neat, how will you define it? If I will say latent heat of heat neat or JE, any one of you? If we say latent heat of JE, JEE or NEET, we can say the effort or energy required to convert you from 12th student to medical student, or yes, the hard work required from your side to convert you from 12th student to engineering student. Okay, so that will be known as latent heat. So the heat or hard work. Okay, so latent heat of vaporization can be termed as energy required to convert liquid into vapor. Okay, so here the process is liquid into is these terms are clear? Latent heat is clear. What do we say clear in Telugu? What do we say clear in Telugu? The energy released or absorbed while transition. Yes. You can term it like that. Oh, that is bit difficult. Earth Mandi. Okay, so Earth Mandi. Sarena. Okay. Sarena means okay, right? Cheppa, tell me, did you get the concept? Cheppu, okay, Cheppu, tell me. Yes, great bro, great.
Let us understand the last concept of today's class, that is vaporization. What is vaporization? We have already understood boiling point. Okay, we have already understood the vaporization process. Sorry, we have already understood the boiling process. Yes, the boiling point also we have understood. What is vaporization? Vaporization means evaporation. If I am asking evaporation, what do you understand by evaporation? Any one of you? You must have seen this phenomena in your daily life, converting liquid into gas. So what's the difference between boiling and evaporation? Any one of you? If we want to understand the difference between evaporation and boiling, how we will understand? What's the difference? Then what is boiling? Certain point heating temperature, evaporation liquid into gas, and again, no, that is condensation. Converting of gas into liquid is condensation. Vapor is called evaporation. Why sunlight? No, some. So let me tell you. Do you understand why the term spontaneous? Do you all know the term spontaneous? Spontaneous. Do you all know the term spontaneous? No, not rapid. Rapid is fast. Rapid means fast. Spontaneous means the process which are occurring by themselves, by itself. They do not require extra force. No, that is not synonym of spontaneous. Spontaneous means the process which are occurring by themselves, not continuous. Just listen me. Just listen me. Stop typing. Stop writing in chat. Spontaneous means the process which are occurring by themselves. I can see there are almost 85 participants in this class, and there will be some participant which will go after the class and study by themselves. So for them, the process of study is spontaneous. But for the others, when their parents put force on you, when your parents will be yelling on you, then only you are going to pick your book and start reading. So in that case, the process is non-spontaneous, right? So spontaneous is a process which is occurring by itself without the external force. Process which occur by itself, right? All the process which are occurring in the nature can be termed as spontaneous process. Yes, voluntarily you can say voluntarily the process which are happening by itself, right? The process which are happening by itself can be termed as spontaneous. So all the process which are occurring in the nature, freezing of ice at the glacier, okay, evaporation of water in the sea, growing of tree plant, these are all spontaneous process. Flow of water from upper height to lower height. Yes, very nice. Flow of gas, intermixing of gases. If there is a barrier, here is N2, and in the other compartment there is O2. If we remove this barrier, N2 and O2 will get intermixed. N2 and O2 will get intermixed by their own. We have done nothing extra. We just removed the barrier. Okay, so this kind of process, the kind of process which are occurring by themselves, are known as spontaneous process. So all the process which are happening in nature can be termed as spontaneous process. So is that clear? Is that clear? Yes, rainfall. Rainfall will be termed as the kind of rainfall. Now there is a time we are creating artificial rain. We are also creating artificial rain. The artificial rain. Yes, cyclone. Yes, very nice cyclone. Cyclone is also a spontaneous process. But the artificial rain, it is non-spontaneous process. Boiling of water. Boiling of water is non-spontaneous process because we are providing heat externally. So the boiling of water is non-spontaneous process. This is non-spontaneous process. But this is spontaneous process. At any temperature, liquid always tries to get converted into vapor. Water heating in sunlight. You can say that is the example of evaporation. That is the example of evaporation. So you stop writing and listen to me. What is the difference between evaporation and boiling? Evaporation can be defined as the interconversion or the conversion of water into vapor or the conversion of liquid into vapor state before the below temperature then boiling point. Okay, the conversion of liquid to vapor at below temperature then boiling point. At any temperature below then boiling point. So we can define is, let me write it here. Spontaneous conversion. It is happening by itself. Spontaneous conversion of liquid into vapor at all temperature, at any temperature less than boiling point. Okay, the temperature when temperature is lesser than the boiling point. Okay, so this is spontaneous process, this is non-spontaneous, this is slow process, this is depends upon the heat provided. And the last point, the important, most important point, evaporation always occurs at the surface. It always occurs at the surface. The particles present at the surface are of highest energy. I'll tell you that, I'll explain that concept in next class, how it is surface phenomena. This is a surface phenomena and this is a bulk phenomena. Okay, this concept I'll be repeating in the next class. Yes, I'll be providing you notes. Guys, first the process should complete. See, these are three basic points. This is spontaneous, this is surface phenomena, but this is non-spontaneous process, external heat is required, and this is bulk phenomena. So I'll be providing you guys notes, okay? But the first, let the process complete, let your strength get fixed, okay? You invite all your friends to join these classes and let them also understand how we are teaching. How our teaching is benefiting you and how we are able to clear your doubts of even 9th and 10th class. We are covering it from the basics. So is that clear, beta? Whatever I have taught today, is that clear? Brownian motion, latent heat, all that clear? Then there is one thing remaining, that is diffusion. I'll be discussing in next class. Diffusion, very important concept. Diffusion. And this bulk and surface phenomena and the graph related to latent heat. I'll be discussing that in next class. See, you must have written what is latent heat, what is Brownian motion. These are some few important concepts. All other things are basic for you. You can just observe in your daily life. You will be able to understand what is the difference between bulk means in the body. Bulk means body. Okay. So I'll be explaining in the next class what is the difference between surface and bulk and diffusion. Diffusion also I'll be explaining in the next class. Okay. So is that clear, whatever I taught today? Any doubt? Is everything clear? Okay. Okay. Notes will be provided to you guys. Okay. Yes. Great. 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 I have seen more answers than the previous class. I have seen. Good. 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 You have told me that earth something to say clear. I have forgotten. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you guys. Yes, artham I in the artham in the. Okay. Right guys, we will meet tomorrow and please come and join at 12:15 sharp. Okay. Nice guys. Thank you all. Thank you for coming. Okay. Thank you guys. Bye.